It's news time. Information is power. Be current. The news headline. Here are the punishments Nnamdi Kanu is going to face if found guilty in court. The news in full. Today, Thursday, October 21st, 2021, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, the leader of the proscribed indigenous people of Biafra, will be charged in court and Nigerians will await the conclusion of his case. The Nigerian government has accused Nnamdi Kanu with treasonable felony and terrorism. Nnamdi Kanu had previously been accused of making incendiary and offensive remarks. The Nigerian government was forced to identify the indigenous people of Biafra as a terrorist organization after rising worries that it would constitute a threat to national security. The leader of proscribed indigenous people of Biafra has been charged with treasonable felony, which is different from treason, and the sentence for treasonable felony differs from the punishment for treason. Based on my online research, I will explain what treason and treasonable offenses are in this essay. Until he is found guilty in a court of law, Nnamdi Kanu is presumed innocent of the charges leveled against him. Treason and treasonable felony. The state can be thought of as a personification of the people because the government symbolizes the state. Anyone attempting to overthrow it or the government has actually been defeated, to be classified as treason. Acts of terrorism, however, are deemed treasonable offenses. Treason is punishable by death, whereas a treasonable offense is penalized by life in prison. Attempting to overthrow the government of the state to which one owes loyalty, either through war or material backing for its opponent. Anyone who declares war on the state to frighten or overpower the president or governor of a state is guilty of treason and should be executed according to the criminal code. Anyone who conspires with others, either within or outside Nigeria, to war against Nigeria is charged with treason according to the criminal code. It is also treasonous to encourage a foreigner to invade Nigeria with armed forces. It should be mentioned that if a country or if a person under the age of 18 is found guilty of treason, he or she will be held at the president's discretion rather than being executed. Similarly, if a pregnant woman commits treason, Section 39, subsection 2 of the Criminal Code mandates that the procedure specified in Section 376 of the Criminal Procedure Act be followed. It makes no difference whether the treasonous act was committed by military members or not. Furthermore, the number of people that participated in the conduct has no bearing on the severity of the crime. The conflict must be for a general or public good. If it is simply for personal gain, it is better classified as a riot or public disturbance. No one may be found guilty of treason until he confesses guilty or there are more than two witnesses to attest that truly he did it. Now, the crime of treasonable felony. A treasonable offense is defined as an act that reveals a desire to commit treason but does not result in any action to carry out their desire. Instead of dealt penalty, this offense carries a life sentence. Section 40 to 43 of the Criminal Code of Nigeria explain the acts that constitute treasonable offenses. The first occurrence of treasonable felony is found in Section 40. Anyone who becomes an accessory after the fact to treason or has knowledge that some person's desire to commit treason but fails to disclose to the proper authorities is guilty of a treasonable crime and faces life in prison according to this law. In addition, anyone who has an intention to commit treason is sentenced to life in prison. Under Section 41 of the Criminal Code, it should be stressed, however, that proof of genuine treason cannot be used as a defense by someone accused with treason. On the other hand, a person who has been dismissed and cleared of the crime of intent to commit treason cannot be tried with treason. Treason is committed by anybody who plans, advises, assists, or engages in any act of war against a traditional chief or a band of citizens. It is worth noting that, according to Section 43 of the Criminal Code, a person cannot be charged for treasonable felony or treason if the offense were committed more than 2 years ago, because Nnamdi Kanu is charged with a treasonable felony rather than treason, he might face life in prison or detention for a period of time rather than death if convicted. He will be dismissed and acquitted if the court's decision is in his favor. As a good citizen, all you need to do right now is to pray for God's mercy, because Nnamdi Kanu is imprisoned, the distraction and killings from the IPOB and ESN will worsen. Also, if he's released, pray that work takes control of his life so that the country can yet again be at peace. This is an analysis by a public writer trying to distinguish between treasonable felony and treason, saying that treason means that means an attempt to overthrow the present government of the state to which one belongs to and one owes allegiance of loyalty, either through war or material backing from their opponent or someone who declares war on the state to frighten or overpower the president or governor of the state, that we can say that the person can be charged or is guilty of treason, and the person, according to the criminal code, deserves death sentence, that is, the person will be executed. And saying that, but if the person is under the age of 18, then it is at the president's discretion to tell what to be done in that case. However, stating that treasonable felony, on the other hand, is when the person, reveals a desire, the person nurses desire, has not effected it, just like treason that has been effected. Once the person nurses a desire, to carry out that desire instead of death penalty as in treason, then the person will be charged to life sentence because it is treasonable felony. Saying that Section 40 to 43 of the Criminal Code of Nigeria Constitution explains this so well, saying that even anyone that has the knowledge, that someone has such a desire to commit treason but fails to disclose to the proper authority is guilty of treasonable felony. Therefore, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu was charged with treasonable felony, so the end result might be life imprisonment if convicted. Until then, if he does not, if he's not guilty, then he will be dismissed. The case will be dismissed and he will be discharged and acquitted if the decision is in his favor. Thanks for listening.